We can make things of Adam. Obviously, they are. Pretty safe. We're going to double it now, yeah? That's it.
Joe, just been watching you, looking nice and sharp. Certainly think that 2 year absence is in the past now, isn't it, mate?
Yeah, definitely, yeah, cool. In the past now, I've had 2 fights now, so yeah, it's good to
get 2 fights, one opponent. Yeah. Well, we have got a new opponent for you, mate. We've
good,
got Ibar Riaz, who I think last time on our show was against Mashadod. A guy that can step in with novices, and a guy that can step in with guys that are ready to fight for titles, as he did with Masha. That was his preparation for when he fought Fazor at the weekend.
Yeah.
Were you down there?
Yeah, I went down, you know, Lou, yeah. Went down, watched it.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was a good show. Like, I was a bit gutted with Masha and Fazor.
And it was developing into a good fight, wasn't it?
It was starting to warm up, but you know, but hopefully there's a rematch in the new year.
Yeah, well, you know, as a VIP man, perhaps a good result for us, you know, because a loss like that, Fazer can handle. That's it was just a clash of heads, a technical decision.
Yeah.
But for Masher, it was a must-win fight, and hopefully he can go on and pick up something. And when Fazer's heels, then perhaps there can be a rematch.
Yeah.
But yourself, you're back out on December the 14th.
December the 14th, yeah, I'm hiding.
And we did mention opponent, Riaz. Like I say, tough man, 170 odd fights. I think he's only been stopped 3, maybe 4 times in that time.
Yeah.
So, but the thing to do against Riaz is if you can get him to go, ooh, which he does quite a lot in fights, then that means you're doing something right. But he's a very tough, durable man. Who's extremely experienced, and will give you. What have you got? 4 rounds with him.
Yeah. Good. I'm happy to be honest. Liam, good. I need a good step up. So, you know, be a good fight for me today.
And who have you been preparing with them? Who have you been moving around with?
Brian
Phillips.
Yeah.
Is Brian fighting on that show as well? Isn't
yeah.
He? Is he?
Yeah.
Who have you got on there? We've got Massey Fagan, Mason Cartwright.
Yeah,
yourself,
Sean Kearns,
Steve Brogan.
Is Colin Day on or as well, did I see?
You might be right. I've not got a
Yeah, there's the poster there.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, up there.
Oh well, all else fails, let's go to the poster. And yeah, and another kid that you have been moving around with it, I've not met him yet, John Doering, is it?
No, I haven't. I'm sparred him, I was meant to spar him last Friday, but
oh right.
No, yeah.
Oh no, I thought you had already sparred him then, sorry. Yeah, but I don't know him. Do you know much about him?
No, not really. Like, so it's been cracking on, keeping my head down in the gym, just seeing him out. So,
how do you think you're fair now? Like I say, a year into this game, and
yeah.
Over 6 months has, actually since you first fought.
Yeah.
But you've been back training hard and as a professional for over a year now. Do you feel like I said before, that ring rust is all gone now, and
yeah,
your confidence is coming back?
Yeah, I've been in the gym. More than enough time now, so I've had enough sparring and enough rounds now.
But the way you fight, it's about confidence, isn't it?
Yeah.
And do you feel as you're getting that confidence, as that's coming back, we're going to see an even better you?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, absolutely. I think once I get this fight up the way, be 3-0 for Christmas. I think I can focus on the big 2020, and I think I'll be out there to put a good show on in 2020, I think.
Because you're only young, what are you, 22, did you?
23.
So, hopefully by the end of next year, you're going to be 24. Maybe you get to 8-0. Maybe you're ready then for a small title, such as a central area.
Definitely, of course, yeah. It's the plan, like, so as long as I keep my head down, keep winning, and you know, keep putting on good performances, I think I'll put myself in a good position.
I'm looking forward to December the 14th. This was a fight, a show that was only going to be a few of our fighters on there, maybe one or two getting out. It seems like, I think we've got about eight fighters or nine fighters on
now,
there.
Isn't it? Yeah.
So it looks like it's a proper big show. Mm-hmm. And there's quite a few meaningful fights on there, because obviously Mason Karak wants to get back to winning ways since he missed out on the WBC Silver International title. And then we've got the rematch with Steve Brogan against
a
pro season.
That'd be good, that'd be interesting. Mate.
Yeah. So it could be a good night, mate, and looking forward to it. Like I say, Riaz gives everyone a good fight. So we'll see how you're developing against him.
Bring it on.
Joe, it's been a pleasure, mate. I'll catch up with you on December the 17th. December the 14th. Hopefully we'll be chatting to you and you'll have win number three, mate.
Of course.
Take care, Joe.
Take care,
bye.
Mate. Ciao.